All right, guys, so we're back in my garage for another episode of the B58 Digest. If you're new to the channel, I use these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in the B58 community. So if that's something that you're interested in, be sure to subscribe to the channel. There will be a lot more of these videos coming out in the future. So today we're going to talk about the MHD Flex Fuel Kit release. And this is something that a lot of you have been waiting on, so I'm really happy that this finally came out. But I do want to clarify something up front because I get a lot of questions about this. The first thing that I want to say is that you do not need this to run ethanol. MHD, Boot Mode, and MG Flasher all offer off-the-shelf maps for ethanol mixes. So if you want to run like the E30 off-the-shelf map or E50 off-the-shelf map, or maybe you get a custom tune for a specific ethanol mix, all you need to do is make sure that, you know, you're doing your due diligence to measure the ethanol content and calculate the mix when you're filling up your car, and it'll run completely fine. This is more of a redundant setup to help the car compensate in case you get your mix wrong. So this will allow you to run any mix that you want from E0 all the way up to E100, and the car will be able to adapt for it with an appropriate flex fuel tune. Now, the other thing is that this is different from the other ethanol analyzers on the market. So there are two different types that you'll see. Some simply measure the ethanol content and send the data to your phone. So again, that's just something that tells you if you got your mix wrong so that, you know, you can drive the car around and then try it again the next time you fill up. None of that actually sends any data to the DME. You're going to need an actual flex fuel kit that comes with the separate module, and that module will wire into your car and send the data to the DME so that it can adjust. So again, if you want to actually run a flex fuel tune where you can run any mix you want at any time you want to allow the car to automatically adjust, then you'll need to make sure you're getting a flex fuel kit with the CAN module, not just a flex fuel sensor. So yeah, sorry, I know that's a little bit redundant, but had to get that out of the way. So now looking at this specific kit, this is made by Bimmer ECU Solutions. He's the same partner with MHD that made their older kits for F-Series BMWs with the N55 engine and the S55 engine. So now they've come out with a solution for the B58 and the B58 TU. And these guys have been in the game for a while. They do a lot of different coding and really complex software solutions. So definitely feel comfortable working with them. I know a lot of us aren't as familiar with them, but obviously seeing them team up with MHD should be a good sign to you that they're a good, reputable company to work with. Now, if you check the website, it doesn't actually show a picture of the kit. They do have the drop down that shows that the B58 option is available now, but it's grayed out. That's because they're all sold out already. So he announced that it was available, people grabbed them all up, and then they were gone. So I just kind of reached out to the owner directly to try to get more information about the kit, and he explained that this actually is a little bit different from what we expected. So this does not install on top of the low-pressure fuel pump like the other kits. So this one is actually going to install underneath the hood on the low-pressure side of the high-pressure fuel pump because there aren't any connectors at the back of the car that can take a signal and communicate with the DME. So the one that they're plugging into is at the front of the car, and that's why it makes more sense to install the flex fuel sensor at the front of the car as well. So that makes a lot more sense, I think, because a couple weeks ago we talked about the Dorch flex fuel kit that came out, and I wasn't sure why it was so different from the others, but they were just making sure that it was close to an area in the car where they could actually take that flex fuel reading and send it directly to the DME with minimal wiring running across the car. So there are a couple locations that this can be done. MHD's, I believe, is going to be in the engine bay somewhere. So again, we'll just kind of have to keep an eye out for that. They are going to be sharing more installation directions in the future, but they just kind of wanted to keep it under wraps since this is like the first fully plug and play solution to come out. They're going to be using a custom wiring harness, so you shouldn't really need to do any splicing or tapping of wires. And it's going to be, you know, completely DIY, something that you can install in 10 or 15 minutes. Now, at the time, this is for automatic cars only. And again, I think it's just the part of the harness or where they're able to plug into. It's a little bit different for manual cars. So they're working on a solution for us. If you have a manual like me, we'll just have to sit tight and wait for that kit or that update to come out. It'll come with custom hoses and quick connect fittings from Precision Raceworks. So it'll be a nice high quality fuel line that'll be tested for leaks before it comes to you, and should be a completely plug and play, seamless install. And then this new kit also comes with an updated board. So now it's going to come with Wi-Fi capability. And what that means is that you can basically update it over Wi-Fi. So if there are any bug fixes or just additional features that they want to add to the module, you'll be able to do that yourself without actually changing any hardware. And then this kit will fit both F and G series. They're going to have slightly different lines depending on the actual platform that you're on, but all of it's going to work, you know, basically the same way. So just keep that in mind as well. So yeah, I think it's pretty cool that I was able to get more information about this. Again, big thanks to Levin over at Bimmer ECU Solutions for kind of explaining some of these details to me. And I'm definitely looking forward to more being shared as time goes on. They should be restocking in the next couple weeks. So again, you'll need to keep an eye on their social media, and they will post up when they get more parts in stock. And they are going to ramp up their production because they know the demand is high. So they're going to need to be able to churn through more parts in order to keep up with that. So yeah, that's it for this video. Again, thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do.